Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Stalker Call of Pripyat. As per usual, we're just jumping, eventually, on in here. Just gotta click in the right places, you know? We are going to be probably traveling back a little ways in this one. We've been spending a lot of area in this, I think it's like the area outside of Yanov or whatever the heck this place is called that we're in. We're gonna be transferring back to the starting zone because there's some stuff I want to do there yet. Brian Whalen actually mentioned in one of my earlier videos that one of the best scanners in the game is apparently in a place with zombies. He wasn't more specific than that, but I actually have a pretty good idea of where he's talking about. There's a sawmill, I think, in the early area, and I seem to recall it being crawling with zombies. In addition to that, we're going to lean back and forth because I can, but in addition to that, I also want to complete some side quests back there, because I think we still have that bloodsucker lair to take care of, so...
Hello.
Let's see, how much to get to Skadovsk? I think that's where we want to go, but I'm going to make sure. Is it? Come on. You're seriously not going to be like, this isn't Skadovsk. Shvachenko Skadovsk. Yeah, okay, so this is the right guy. This is going to be 1,000, sure. Let's get out of here. Back to Noob Town. Well, it's not really Noob Town. There are nasty things around here. I have been attacked by bloodsuckers in this area and stuff before. So it's not, you know, all... you know, a bed of roses, I guess you could say. There is danger here. It's just not as... I don't know, I wouldn't say ever-present as the...
So do me a favor and put yours away.
I don't have a gun, I have a grenade, man! Okay, well it's late, so we're gonna... I keep wanting to use E as my use key. Apparently Fallout is still on my brain, even though at the time of this recording, that series is done, so I wanna come in here and check really quickly. Do I really want slugs? We're gonna leave the slugs here. Damn it. If I could, you know, properly drag this thing. And... where did that artifact that I had go? Did I vendor the thing? I must have sold the thing like a freaking idiot. I'm not particularly worried. I'm sure we'll find another one. But it's kind of irksome. Okay, let's see. Let us sleep until now-ish. Are we gonna get an emission? Yay, we got an emission. It means I don't have to do... You watching me sleep, bud? That's... kind of creepy. Stay away from me. This is my diet sausage. Hey guys.
Start talking, buddy.
How are you?
Hey guys. Bye guys. Alright, so it is like 5 in the morning. Yeah, it is early. So I suppose, you know, set out early, get back early. So I think this is where we want to go up here. So can I just like set a marker? No, no. Okay. Well, we are wanting to go. Let's see, this is north. We are wanting to go northwest. North, wow. Let us... made my gun out. Thank you. I think we're actually probably gonna be pretty well served by the deagle in this area. I'm really not too worried about wandering monsters. I got some dead flesh over here. That'd be flesh? Is that like singular and plural? I don't know. I got some more dead... look at that thing! It's so derpy looking. That's like what I look like in the morning. I wake up and before I've had my morning caffeine injection, that's about where I sit mentally. That is neither here nor there. Okay, so this is the hill oh places where I'll fall in when I'm not paying attention because I'm a jackass, so I need to actually pay attention to where I'm going here. I just kind of go running, well, like a jackass, I suppose. Even though it's my favorite thing. There's actually a road up here. I suppose it would be a little bit more logical to just jump on the road. Let's see, okay, so sawmill is due west. Basically, just follow the road and we will get there. I think this is the right place. I think. So in reality, there's probably like a 60% chance. Oh yeah, this place is cooked. I don't think I really need to... have this on. I'm sure there's probably goodies in there. Can I, like, pull out my bolts? Okay, then. I think there's one, like, right in front of me here. No? Alright. Looks like there's one right in front of me there. But seriously, though, there's, like... Unless they're moving, maybe. Which they might be. I think they might be moving. I'm not gonna risk it. We're gonna pass for the time being. We'll come back. See, I think that this is the place. I'm like 90% sure. We're gonna actually take out our good gun for this. Well, I say our good gun, but I'm actually pretty satisfied with how well our little submachine gun works too. It's just this thing is better for the long range engagements, which is probably what I'm gonna be doing here. See if we can't. Wow, we can't. I need to get a better scope for this thing. Something that's like a legit long range scope. This is like, I mean, it's a little long range, I guess, but it could be better. Yeah, I'm fairly certain this is the place that I wanna be. So we'll poke around here, see if we can't find anything worth anything. I'm probably not gonna be able to get close enough. Like, I shouldn't say get close enough, get a nice line of sight on the place without pulling aggro on these things. However, we're sitting pretty accurate here. I think I don't know if that thing's dead or wounded. Now it's dead. Okay. Cause yeah, as you can see, they've got numbers over there. Oh, come on now. Whatever. Yeah, as you can see, they get right back up if you don't drop them. And reload, I'm gonna move in a little bit here. As with like every other group of zombies that I've ever encountered in this game, I'm not really particularly threatened by these guys. There are a lot of them here though. Like that is one thing that I am fully aware of. Where is he? One of them sees me, but I don't see it. I don't know. Not worried yet. Come on. I'm thinking that maybe the time for stealth is past. We'll try with the deagle and see how we go here. You always have to double tap these fools. Although I think that one might be like legit dead. Hey there, bud. Oh, nice. I'm proud of that one. Unintentional headshot. You're not dead. You are now. Okay. Whoa, bud. Bud, come on now. Dead now. Wait for it. Making sure. Get a little bleeding going on. I'm not, you know, afraid of death or anything, but yeah, as you can see, there's like five of them just in this direction alone. Let's see here, what do you have on you? I think that's some bullets I can use, and a bear detector, no, it's an echo detector, just like the one we have. And unload. Now, keep in mind that the game does not pause while I am looting bodies. Holy crap, that is a prime target. Come on, grenade. I think I might have lit one on fire. Accidentally popped an anti-rad. My fat fingers. Where is he? One on the ground. Oh, hey. Let's see, so I've got five of them in front of me at least. I think a couple are on the ground though. Yeah. Seriously? Seriously? Dogs too? Man, I'm gonna just start stabbing these dogs. Cover! Oh. Ow! Freaking dogs, man. Well, you go up into the attic and just go all snipey on them. Just checking here, making sure. Nothing loot worthy. Alright, our gun is wearing out. Which, I don't know how worried I am about that, truth be told. Seriously, dude. You have one of what I have. Now I have it too. Alright, so as you can see by our mini-map, we killed a lot of zombies here. So looting these guys is gonna be kind of a pain in the ass. But what I'm probably gonna do is just take all of their stuff until I'm encumbered and then just start dropping things, because that seems to work pretty well. Not there yet. Don't think I'm there yet. Nope. There's a Viper 5. I'm gonna take that because bullets. AKM. There we are. Oh, come on. I was gonna say, I bet I should be able to get into his, like, feet from here. Okay. Unload. So yeah, we're, zombies are, I think, pretty decent for just kind of stocking up on ammo. They're not, obviously, where you're gonna wanna head for, you know, high quality drops. Cause as you see, all of their stuff is just like hilariously damaged. But what are you gonna do? Okay, there we go. So we've actually picked up quite a bit of extra weight worth of just crap off of these guys, basically. Turns out bullets and stuff are heavy. Okay. Let's see here. At least we're getting some of the bandages. I was gonna say backpacks for whatever reason. How much do these things weigh? What am I carrying that weighs so much? Oh, I accidentally took a gun. Okay, that'll do it. Like, what did I pick up? Obviously, we're still encumbered, but I'll further, you know, chew through stuff once we're done here. I don't mind being a little encumbered because it's not like I'm sprinting anywhere. Okay, I've already dealt with you because I looted you in the middle of combat. This guy, though, not so much. I'm not looting, like, their guns. I know I probably should be for, you know, maximal loot whoring, but, you know, if I were playing on my own, I would be. Oh, hey, rad truck. If I were playing on my own, I would be, but since I'm playing for other people, I kind of want to, you know, move along a little ways. Oh, man, I actually, being near that thing screwed me up. All right, I'm gonna take these things because, like, that's a gun I have, so I want to be able to actually pull ammo for that. That's another, Deagle? Cora? Black Kite, nope. We're actually coming out ahead, I think, with regards to lootables here. Okay, I can't even loot that guy for whatever reason. Just wanted to take these because I think this is ammo for, oh, this is not ammo for this thing. I don't even know what this is ammo for. I do not have an AK-74. The temptation, though, is to get one. Okay, what do you have? Sorry, Private Gorikin. I like that they actually all have names and stuff. It's a little bit of characterization that they really didn't have to do. The devs didn't really have to do, but it's appreciated that they did. I'm gonna unload this. I really, really wish that there was, like, a quick way to loot in this game, though. That is something that I'm probably gonna be kind of whinging about until we're done, is, you know, double-clicking every single item, kind of a pain in the ass. I wish I could just, like, right-click and it goes to my inventory. Ah, and I am overloaded. I just took his gun, get rid of that. Okay, let's get rid of these. Oh, seriously, one at a time, let's get rid of these. I don't really need too many of these as my chair creaks along in the background because I've got, you know, anti-rad drugs and stuff. So we should be able to move now, yes. Okay. Take all the bullets. And I think I just actually took some vodka, yes, because force of habit. Get rid of the vodka. Oh, okay, so I want that. We're at least coming out ahead on ammo. I can at least appreciate that. Like, we're coming out pretty solidly ahead on ammo here, which is nice. And I think this is the last one right here. Your bullets. Thanks, Nil Tramp. Alright, now I want to say this is obviously the wood mill right up here. We're going to poke around. Actually, I want to go up into this attic. I totally forgot about it. Ah, no running. We got to lose 5 kilograms worth of junk, which is probably going to be harder than I want to admit. Okay, that'll hurt us. Up the ladder. And do we have anything? Holding on the F key. So we got some energy drink, bandages, and first aid kits. And some vodka, which I don't want. Some grenades, some 9x39 ammo. Some 5x40 or 5.45 ammo. Tools for basic work, yes. And some AP rounds over there. This was actually quite lucrative. So I don't suppose I can just like eat a shitload of food. Delicious. And we're no longer encumbered. Funny how that works. Okay, and that's it for in here. Well, this place alone was, like, this structure alone was pleasing. Did I just take that vodka? I was gonna say, like, I don't think I just took that vodka, but the text disappeared from my screen. I don't trust this game any further than I can throw it. Okay, so we're done in here. Time to move up to the main and secondary facilities. Probably gonna wanna climb that. There might be goodies up top there too. I don't know, we might have actually killed all of the zombies. I'm hopeful that we did, but I'm not gonna assume that we did. Alright, I hear gunfire, which leads me to believe there might be some more zombies floating around. I think they will attack wildlife. I'm not entirely sure. There is actually a faction in this game, if I recall correctly, that they are friendly towards. I can't remember who they are, though. I think it's that group of people that we found in the other area that can't remember like anything and are trying to get into that base. I think it's that faction. All right. So let's see what we got in here. I'm not seeing any zombies. That's a plus. Not seeing a whole hell of a lot else either. Unless you want an axe. Okay. Could sleep in a bed. Alright, so this place is looking a little bust. I thought I remembered there being more in here than there is, but that's, I guess, just getting chalked up to poor memory. Oh, maybe we can't climb up here. That's gonna be disappointing. Yeah, maybe. Maybe. We'll see here. See if we can't get up here and finagle our way into something interesting. Oh, not looking like it. I mean, we can follow this thing that goes freaking all the way back home, I suppose. I don't know. Because, yeah, that doesn't look like it's going to be very conducive when it comes to us getting up there. Man, this engine, like, I just realized, like, the lighting as I dodge. Apparently you can dodge or something. I don't know how I just did that. I just noticed that the lighting is actually, you know, you got some light based off of the bars and stuff. I'm easily impressed by stuff like that. I still maintain that Path of Exile has one of the coolest lighting systems ever, just because of the prison zone in that game. But I don't know, this, like, I'm sad that this is the last Stalker game. I mean, I know that there are some people working on other Stalker games. Like, I know Survivarium or whatever it was called was supposed to be one, and the last thing I heard about that was not good. So I don't know, I really like this kind of game, like the leaning more towards realism post-apocalypse, although this, I actually don't know, thinking on it, I don't know what the state of the rest of the world is like in this setting. And I've never really looked into it either. Is, like, the rest of the world fucked? I wouldn't imagine it is. From what I would guess, it's just the area around Chernobyl is just, you know, this killing ground because reasons. Alright, so this is where our little walk here ends, I think. Yeah. Well, we're honestly not too far away from home, so I'm gonna just drop down. And yes, I know that this is a slow walk, but we have enough crap on us that I don't really want to vendor at the moment that I think we're just gonna have to hoof it. It's not bad. Like, there's the boar shack. I call this the boar shack because one time when I played this game, there was one of those giant boars. I thought I just heard a giant boar, actually. There's one of those giant boars meandering around in there. So it is like forever the boar shack now. Even though it's probably not often a home of boars. Okay, so yeah, we want to just go straight east. And once we're done with this, we will go and get the... I think we still have to get the gas for smoking out those bloodsuckers. And we'll do that and probably call it an episode. We're at 20 minutes. I think that 10 minutes, give or take, will be enough to do this. If not, well, we might just go a little bit over. That's okay. It's weird this week. This is all I've got to record. Yeah, I just had to do that. This is all I have to record this week. It's very strange, only... Like, I say it's strange, but it's basically going back to my old Monday, Wednesday, Friday schedule. I've just kind of gotten used to having to do 2 episodes of stuff a day. And, you know, for this week we don't have to because Fallout's done and I've got to get the voting stuff posted. And, well, it'll be ideally posted by the time this is up. But, okay, so we want to keep going this way. That's a red herring over there. But yeah, it's strange. And no, that doesn't mean you're getting 2 episodes of this. I'm actually probably going to be doing this in Shadowrun. I was hoping that, you know, restarting Shadowrun and stuff, I'd have time to get recordings in for more Shadowrun and Demon Souls and stuff, or Dark Souls 2, rather. It's just that work has been really, really busy, and I've just, like, I've not been struggling to get this stuff recorded, it's just finding time to record additional stuff on top of it. Because, I mean, I've basically doubled my weekly video output to keep these, you know, an episode of each thing on Monday, Wednesday, Friday, as opposed to just one episode of a thing on Monday, Wednesday, Friday. But, I'm okay with the pace right now. It's not overwhelming. Come Christmas time, I might have to pull back because... it gets insanely busy. I work in shipping, and obviously Christmas time is, you know, peak time, and that'll freaking suck.
Hello.
But we're not there yet.
Good luck to you.
Like, he's like, hello, good luck. Okay, the first thing I want to do is come in here. Okay, and I want to drop off bullets that I'm not going to use. Okay, so that uses that. That uses... I actually have extra ammo for my little... SMG here. Okay, so shotgun shells. Alright, so shotgun shells. I'm gonna move stuff so that I can... Come on. Shotgun shells. These things. These. And then these. Okay, so everything else can go in here. I think all of these... I'm fairly certain that these are rounds for the AK-74. Fairly certain. And again, I'm carrying like a boatload of bandages and stuff, and I don't need to carry this much. I actually like that they've made ammo and stuff very heavy in this game. I like it because it forces you to kind of plan when you go out. You can't just be a jackass and be like, well, I'm going to carry 1,000 rounds out with me. Because, you know, I guess 1,000 pounds actually weighs quite, or 1,000 rounds, I should say, actually weighs quite a bit. So that's nice. I'm actually going to leave some food in here, too. There. We've got our diet sausages. We don't need no other food. So where is work guy? Hey, buddy. Right, tools. Nice, which ones? Basic work tools. 1,000, nice. I need tools for fine work and calibration. Yeah, well, I don't have those. Can you not do these? Tools for fine work, damn it. And he also needs vodka because he's an asshole. Whatever. I just need to repair my shit. So we should be able to do, let's see, fine work. Yeah, so if we give him booze, we can get some additional weapon upgrades going on here, which is actually kind of tempting. Go ahead and repair this guy. It's actually, we didn't damage this thing all that much considering how much we used it. Okay, so I think that's all of our guns repaired. So I'm gonna get out of here. Hey, Owl, I've got some info for you. Apparently not. I was wondering if he would take this.
A statue? If you got something, spill the beans. If not, take a hike.
Spill the beans. I don't know. Oh, Owl, you're a dick. Used to locate anomalies. Let's see here. Distance isn't an area of frequency. Only be used to locate the most common. I know what kind I'm looking for. It's like a Varus or something. It starts with a V. And I'm not gonna get one. I'm not gonna upgrade until I get the V one. Let's see, so what kind of, yeah, this is 5.45 ammo. I think this is all that. No, maybe it's not actually. Maybe it's not. What is this? Is a shotgun? Oh, old school. Nice. That's like a break action then. Can appreciate that. Let's see. Is this a long range? 5x. Here, we'll sell these. I want to see what my optic is on this thing. Attach scope. 4x. All right. I want to buy that scope from him. Because this is a better object than the one we have. And this thing, I could put it on my shotgun, but that just seems so unnecessary. Like, don't get me wrong. Let me guess, I can't put this, I was gonna say, yeah, just watch, I won't be able to put it on this stupid thing. Of course, because, you know, why would I be able to do that? Damn it. I knew it. Like, as soon as I hit buy, I'm like, just watch. And there, I just had to pay another 1,000 to get my old one back. Yeah, we just got screwed. Whatever. God damn it, we're already at 30 minutes. That's not gonna do. We're gonna go a little long today, I think. I wanna check these gas vent things that we're looking for. Where is it? Is it? Al claims you'll find gas canisters at the deserted military convoy. Well, where is the deserted military convoy at? Because I don't have a little dit on my map unless it's in a different area, which I suppose could be. Find poisonous gas. Unless... Is this the deserted military convoy? Oh, okay, yeah, this is the deserted military convoy. I remember all the vehicles on this bridge. Okay. All right. So we'll go and investigate that. I think it's still pretty early. Like, what, 8? 9 o'clock, going on 10. So that whole trip out, hey there, I see you. I see you, Flesh. I'm coming for you. I'm coming. I'm gonna get you. Come back here, I'm not done with you yet. Knife fight. Metal Gear. Because really, they're not worth the bullets. Yeah, look at that, you always run faster with a knife. If Counter-Strike has taught me anything, it's how to regurgitate old videos from the YouTubes back in the day when it wasn't filled with random people doing stupid prank videos. This is the right way, I hope. Yes, awesome. I am pleased. I don't know, the view on this knife, it seems like super zoomed in, like our guy is like carrying it either right next to his face or his eyes are in his chest. I don't know, it's kind of disconcerting. I'm gonna pull out a real gun here. I am pleased with how much ammo we have. Like, I'm comfortable. I don't feel like we're, you know, desperate for bullets or anything, which is nice. We're kind of a little lower than I'd like to be for our long-range rifle, but, you know, whatever. Okay, ranger station, we've already, I think, poked around in here. I think. I honestly don't remember. Hi, Rain. It's been a while since I've seen you, and by a while I mean like probably 20 minutes. Well, now this looks promising. Yeah! An SPSA 14. We found a stash! Damn right, I found a stash. What is this? Automatic shotgun! Nice! So it's like a Spaz 12 type deal. Well, see, the question then becomes, which is better? Damage is up there. Here, let's compare. Compare and contrast. It's got better handling, but I'm actually pretty happy with our Eliminator. I'm actually kind of... It's actually in good repair. I'm going to hold on to it. We're going to vendor it. I'm kind of curious to find a equipment list for this game just to kind of see what kind of goodies we have to look forward to. Like, the Eliminator is like a named barreled shotgun, or not barreled, drum-fed shotgun. Kind of makes me wonder if it's not like a higher-end gun. I don't even remember where I found that thing. I don't even remember where I found that thing. I'm not even gonna deal with that place. It's dark and scares me, and we have to go to do this, because... Bloodsucker gas, ah, that's right, this frickin' gravity field of bullshit. Little thing, aid me. It's beeping. It's like there must be things nearby. Like, is there one there? I don't know. Oh my god. Now. Screw you, nature. I got bolts. Oh shit, that wasn't even intentional, but I'll take it. Okay, that's trouble over there. Can I cross here? Yes. Okay, there's... I actually didn't know that you could... If you hold down the right mouse button, you have a little charge-up meter. I wonder if you can do that with grenades, too, get some better distance. Whoa. That was an explosive bolt I just threw there. I don't know my own power. Leave me alone, you devil spawn puffer things. Okay, so we're looking for some gas. Hey there. First aid kits and grenades. It's not gas, but it's acceptable. You have anything? No? Ah, that looks promising. How do we get up there? How do I... Well, hello there. Grab that. Damn it, grab it. Find keys to container. Okay, what does it say? Top secret order from Colonel P.P. Slavin. In accordance with this order, members of Chemical Protection Unit number 423 are to be familiarized with the following information. Keys to container with parent B3 chemical solution are held by Colonel P.P. Slavin and Lieutenant Colonel K.S. Vlasov. Convoy order starting from the front, deputy unit, commander's vehicle, escort vehicle, APC, transport vehicle, APC, escort vehicle, unit commander's vehicle. Copies of the orders would be handed out and disseminated amongst the assholes. All right, so his key should be down there somewhere. But first, AKM-74. This thing's probably in good they're in good condition, so I don't wanna just like trash them. I feel bad. Yeah, he should be like right back here. His key should be. How did I miss it? Unless I'm being a jackass and it got like... Oh, don't tell me like one of these things got driven off the road or something. I can't even see down there, and if I'm not careful, I'm gonna end up pitching myself off. Come on. Alright, I don't see any down that side. Eh. I certainly don't see any down that side. Well, that's good at least. Okay, so no keys in here. Of course, there's no bodies either. So, you know, that's a thing. We'll check this one up here. This is gonna be probably trouble, isn't it? Hey there. A bunch of bullets. Like, holy crap. Thank you. Ah, and I'm now over encumbered. Damn it. So I'm gonna go ahead and guess that the shotguns are gonna be worth more, Jesus, than the AKM. Do we have a vehicle down here? I don't see one. That doesn't mean that there isn't one. I don't suppose they're gonna give me a map note either. No, of course not. We can't do this the easy way. Alright, what was the order again? Starting from the front. So, yeah, his vehicle was in the back. That's our vehicle. Number 8, APC. Oh, shit.
No!
Ah. So, yeah, there are missing vehicles here, because there should have been one more in front of this one. And, what was it here? Let's see here. One. Alright, APC. Yeah, it looks like there's a vehicle missing from the back. Conveniently, both of the ones that I'm looking for. What a twist. Like, it just can't be easy. I'm gonna go to 40, I think. 40 minutes. So. Alright, mad dash. Screw you, nature. Ha! Outwitted by a man. Okay, I'm gonna come down here. Oh shit! Ow. Thanks, ladder. You really helped me out there. You were totally a bro. Yeah, I think I see a vehicle down there. Yep. Well, here's one. Eh. Well, that's a radio. Or it's a safe, as the case may be. So this is the exact same orders, and key B, awesome. So now we just have to find key A, which should be, well, you know, I think back here, but they didn't fall through, so I don't think it would be back here. I'm gonna come back and check it out, just to be safe. But, I don't know, guys, like, this is making me wonder. Man. See here. Go down to ground. I just want to see, like, under the bridge. Just to make sure. Oh! Look at that. Some anti-rads and bandages. Thanks, game. I think I didn't notice that my character's head was clipping into the bridge there. I noticed that shit. Let's see here. Yeah, there's nothing down here. Maybe he's in an earlier part of the bridge. We'll go up and check. Okay. We'll just go around here. I suppose I can put my little science-a-majigger away. Technical term there, guys. Technical term. Science-a-majigger. You can tell I'm a real astute gentleman by my usage of big words and stuff. Alright, so let's kinda meander our way back here and ideally not get. Nah, leave me alone! Not get eaten by the drift. Okay. Yeah, here's the last vehicle. Unless there was like a crate in here and I just completely missed it, which. You know, I know me and it's likely, so I figured I would check. And I hope they didn't make this key like some little ass object on the ground. If they did that, I'm just gonna like, oh, there's this vehicle right there. I walked right past the damn thing. All right, we're gonna cross over. Oh, this is gonna end poorly. Do it, run.
Yeah, no.
Get out of here. Get out of there. Oh, damn. Ah, man. Oof. That was violent. Alright, dude. Where's your stuff? There's your stuff. Give me this. Oh, he's got a second document. What's this? Order this. Oh, it's a top secret order. Let's see here. Chemical Protection Unit number 423, relocate from Sector B103 to Sector A19 to conduct field testing of Perrin B3 chemical solution on near combat conditions. Nice. Colonel P.V. Slavin, unit commander, is responsible for conducting the tests. Lieutenant Colonel K.S. Volov, deputy unit commander, is responsible for transport and security. Taking that. So now do we have a map note? Seriously, guys. How am I supposed to know where the stuff is? Oh, wait, no, I think it was on one of these vehicles back here. Eh. I got run speed. You can't hurt me. Okay. I think it was, yeah, it's in this back truck here, and I'm just being dumb. I don't know. All right. Let's get in here, and it just can't make it easy on me. I gotta go, like, over the truck instead of just game. Come on now. Thank you. Use keys. Here we go. Canister of Perrin B3 gas. Holy shit, that stuff's heavy. We should be able to carry it, though. Yes. Find the ventilation shaft. Alright, that's way the hell back over there. And we are at 41 minutes. We've actually gone over a little bit. I'm not particularly worried, but I'm going to call an episode here. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time, and I will see you all next time. We are going to see what this gas does to bloodsuckers. I'm assuming that it's going to kill them, but I might have to fight some, and if I do, that's going to make me sad. But we'll find that out then, as opposed to now. So, as per usual, take it easy, and until next time.